Now let me read chapter 33, verse 1. And Jacob lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, Esau came, and with him 400 men. And he divided the children unto Leah and unto Rachel and unto the two handmaids. He wanted to spare his family, you see. So he separated them. And he put the handmaids and their children foremost, and Leah and her children after, and Rachel and Joseph hindermost. And he passed over before them, bowed himself to the ground 7 times until he came near to his brother. You know, I'd love to have had a picture of Jacob meeting his brother Esau. I suppose he was a mile from him, and he started bowing. He came with his hat in his hand, because this man Esau has 400 men with him, and this man Jacob doesn't know how he's coming, whether it's as a friend or foe. Now notice, though, verse 4. And Esau ran to meet him and embraced him and fell on his neck and kissed him, and they wept. Well, they're twins, they're brothers, and let bygones be bygones. I think Esau, God had certainly touched him because he had sworn vengeance that he'd kill his brother. Now, will you notice, and he lifted up his eyes and saw the women and the children and said, Who are those with thee? And he said, The children which God hath graciously given thy servant. Then the handmaidens came near, they and their children. They bowed themselves. And Leah also with her children came near and bowed themselves. And after came Joseph near and Rachel, and they bowed themselves. And he said, What meanest thou by all this drove which I met? And he said, These are to find grace in the sight of my Lord. Jacob, I think, believes for a moment that his strategy of approaching his brother had worked. But notice, it wasn't necessary. And listen now to Esau, and what a change. And Esau said, I have enough, my brother. Keep that thou hast unto thyself. I have enough, my brother. That's what Esau said. You didn't need to send that to me. After all, Esau had plenty. And Jacob said, Nay, I pray thee, if now I found grace in thy sight, then receive my present at my hand. For therefore I have seen thy face as though I had seen the face of God, and thou wast pleased with me. Take, I pray thee, my blessing that is brought to thee, because God hath dealt graciously with me, and because I have enough. And he urged him, and he took it. You know, this is almost a humorous scene. When, up to the time that Jacob left home, these two fellows were after each other in the flesh, each one trying to get something from the other, and especially Jacob. And now we find Jacob in a new office altogether. Here he is insisting that his brother take a gift, and his brother insists, Why, Jacob, I have plenty. I don't need it. You don't need to give it to me. It's not essential. And Jacob insisted. And believe me, friends, something's happened to the boy. He's like Zacchaeus up the tree, you know, when our Lord got him down and went into his home. Something happened to Zacchaeus when he came out. He said, I'm no longer the tax collector that's been stealing from people and being dishonest. I now want to return not only anything I've taken in a wrong way, and you can be sure he had, but I want to restore it fourfold. What a difference. What a change had taken place. And you certainly knew which house Jesus had visited. And certainly here's a man that's a little different than the man that we met before. What a change. Before, he traded a bowl of soup to get a birthright. Now he's willing to give flocks and herds to his brother for nothing. And his brother doesn't want to take it. And he insists. Now his brother finally took it. He urged him and he took it. Why? Because in that land, in that day, to have refused a gift that was urged upon you like this would have been an insult. And so Esau takes it. And he said, Let us take our journey and let us go, and I will go before thee. Esau said, You'll return back to the land, Now let me go before you and show the way. I'll be protection for you also.